chote utataka nitakupa.
Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. Itega Ofane Lungu back with another reaction video. If you're new to this channel, make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course, do not forget to subscribe. Like I said, my name is Fanny Lungu, and on this channel, we post reaction videos each and every day. So if there's something that you guys want us to react to, let us know by dropping the link in the comment section below, and we'll do it for you. Today, I'm going to be reacting to 10 surprise and halal things in Islam. A big shout out to the person that suggested this. So without wasting time, let's get into the video.
Typically, when it comes to Islam, many people associate it with everything that is forbidden. However, in this episode, we're going to be looking at 10 halal things in Islam. Welcome back, guys, to another episode of FTD Facts. My name is Leroy Kenton. And one thing to know is that the term halal doesn't necessarily mean the opposite of haram. Halal, however, is related to how meat is prepared according to Islam. But in casual conversations, halal sometimes is used to mean things that are permissible. And that's the basis we're going to use for this episode. So let's jump into this episode. 10 things that are surprisingly halal in Islam. At number 10, we have forex trading. There is no question that currency exchange is permissible in Islam as long as there is no interest charges added both ways and that the exchanger has a valid reason to anticipate a probable profit based upon any analysis that they've done rather than just relying on strictly gambling. It's reported that the Prophet Muhammad in the Hadith said these words: gold for gold, silver for silver, wheat for wheat, barley for barley, dates for dates, salt for salt, like for like, same for same, hand to hand. If the types are different, then sell however you like, so long as it is hand to hand. At number 9, we have the halal thing of marrying up to 4 women in Islam. Traditional Sunni and Shia Islamic marital jurisprudence allow Muslim men to be married to multiple women, which is a practice known as polygyny and polygamy. And this total is up to having 4 of these partners at a time.
Why does Islam allow men to marry 4 wives? What is the wisdom behind it? Why?
There are certain rules that needs to be applied for this to happen, but it is still considered halal. In the Quran, Surah 4, verses 3, it says the following: and if you fear that you will not deal justly with the orphan girls, then marry those that please you of other women, 2 or 3 or 4. But if you fear that you will not be just, then marry only 1 or those your right hand possesses. That is more suitable that you may not incline to injustice.
Number 1, Islam was not the first religion who came up with the idea of having more than one wife. All these great messengers, the prophets of Allah, they had more than one wife. They said for every 16 girls, there's a 1 boy that is born. Islam says no. These women, they have rights to be loved, to be wives, to have children, and so on.
And now that kind of leads us into number 8, and that is marrying a non-Muslim. Islamic marriage rules between Muslim men and non-Muslim women are regulated by Islamic principles. There are some restrictions, though, to whom a Muslim can marry, specifically a Muslim man. According to the Quran, Surah 5, verses 5, it says this: this day, all good foods have been made lawful, and the food of those who were given the scripture is lawful for you, and your food is lawful for them. And lawful in marriage are chaste women from among the believers and chaste women from among those who were given the scripture before you, when you have given them their due compensation, desiring chastity, not unlawful sexual intercourse, or taking secret lovers. And whoever denies the faith, his work has become worthless, and he in the hereafter will be among the losers. Partying comes in at number 7. It is okay to have parties. In Islam, having a good time and relationships with relatives and friends, it's actually an obligation, even if that relative isn't a Muslim. So therefore, having gatherings with friends and families and parties and all of that, it's actually recommended. As long as you keep in mind that the certain gatherings should not have any sort of gossip or, you know, things that humiliate other people or the use of bad words or other things that are prohibited in Islam. Let's talk about beautifying for your husband or wife next. Both men and women are at certain times required to appear in the way that looks pleasant for their life partner, especially when they're alone in their private moments. It is considered to be a great merit for a woman to put on her makeup, wear jewelry and perfume to really charm and please her husband. And it's also a great merit for a man to keep himself well groomed, well dressed, and all of that in a way to gratify his wife. But the Quran does put some guidelines to this, and that is found in Surah 24, verses 31. And that says, "And tell the believing women to reduce some of their vision and guard their private parts and not expose their adornment except that which necessarily appears thereof, and to wrap a portion of their head covers over their chest and do not expose their adornment except to their husbands." Then the Quran does go on to list certain close relatives who a woman can be seen beautified in the presence of. All right, guys, so I know this video is talking a lot about halal things in Islam, but we did a video series about 10 haram things in Islam. If you haven't seen that already, I definitely want you to check it out. I'll have a link to that below in the video description section. We've done 5 videos so far. We're probably going to be continuing. Who knows? We'll see. But for now, let's continue with this episode on halal things in Islam. Next up at number 5, we're going to look at traveling and camping. Now, the Prophet Muhammad has been recorded to have said these words: "Travel so that you stay fine and healthy." So going out in nature and parks and camping grounds, even traveling far distances in other cities and spending time overnight in nature actually can really help change your mood. There's a lot of lessons that you can learn out in nature, as well as it can help strengthen a believer's relationship with God. Number 4, let's look at owning pets. So according to Islam, human beings are allowed to use animals, but only if the rights of the animal is 100% fully respected. The owner of an animal must do everything to benefit the animal. But some people believe that the animal that is kept should never, ever, ever be a dog, because Islam does forbid keeping dogs except guard dogs and hunting dogs. Now, in the hadith narrated by Abu Hurairah, it says this: "Whoever keeps a dog that is not a dog for hunting, herding, livestock, or farming, 2 kirats will be deducted from his reward each day." Dancing comes in next at number 3. Now, this is a little bit of a sensitive one because there's quite a bit of different opinions, but it's said that there is no problem in dancing in itself. However, if the dancing does include some sort of sexually provocative actions, that is forbidden. And it doesn't make any difference to what the type of music is that a person is dancing to. So generally speaking, if dancing is done in a sexually provocative way, that can lead to committing other forbidden acts or involves having a bad effect over somebody, then it is forbidden. But generally speaking, outside of that, dancing is allowed in Islam. We're almost at the end of this episode. We got 2 more to go. And number 2, we have divorcing up to 3 times. So when marital harmony cannot be achieved at all by the couple, the Quran does allow and even advises the spouses to bring the marriage to a full end. In the Quran, it says this: "And if he has divorced her for the 3rd time, then she is not lawful to him afterward until after she marries a husband other than him. And if the latter husband divorces her or dies, there is no blame upon the woman and her former husband for returning to each other if they think that they can keep within the limits of Allah. These are the limits of Allah, which He makes clear to the people who know." And that is taken specifically from the Quran, Surah 2, verses 230. We made it to number 1. The halal thing that we're going to end off this episode with is praying in other worship houses. So not many people know this. Well, when I say not many people, I'm talking about people that aren't necessarily familiar with the religion of Islam. But did you know that Muslims can pray anywhere? Although it is recommended to pray with others in a mosque, but it is permissible to pray in the house of worship for Christians, for example, or anyone else who does not follow the religion of Islam, because the general meaning of the words of the Prophet Muhammad is this: "The earth has been made for a place of prostration and a means of purification. So wherever a man of my ummah is, when the time for prayer comes, let him pray." And that's in the hadith narrated by Al-Bukhari, number 323. All right, guys, so that brings us to the end of this episode. This was a look at 10 surprisingly halal things in Islam. Let me know down below in the comment section, did any of these surprise you? Whether you're Muslim or not, sound off down below, join in on the conversation. Also, don't forget to check out the recommended video that I talked about. I'll have that again below in the video description comment section, so you can click on that link when you're finished watching this. And that's gonna be right now, because that's it for me, guys. I'm gonna get out of here. I'm gonna work on some more videos for you guys. Until next time, stay awesome, stay educated, and I'll see y'all soon.
Very interesting video. I'm shocked by the fact 7 or 8, I'm not even sure what number it was, the fact that you can actually marry out of your religion. That's interesting. How does that work? Can someone please explain that to me? Another thing is it just, does that only favor men, or women can also marry outside their religion? And how do they even make things work? What happens from there? Another, the dog one, that surprised me as well. I wouldn't even want to keep animals in the first place, but whew, I wish that law was for everyone, because I really don't understand why people like keeping dogs or just pets in general. And the first one, praying in other places of worship, that's interesting. I mean, imagine you go to a place where you can't find a mosque and you have to pray in another place because of what I just said, you can't find a mosque. That's very interesting, and that's very big of people that would allow such actions to take part. So those three are the ones that surprised me for me. And what was new to you guys? Do you have anything to say? Make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with a friend, and of course, do not forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in my next reaction video.